Greetings and welcome to Pop Culture Beasts Halloween Horror Picks. I'm your host, Ryan Stockstad, and today we're going to talk about a 90s horror movie that I guarantee will make you squirm.
Open wide.
Please, somebody help me!
He is high!
The Dentist.
The Dentist, 1996. The horror movie for anyone who ever had a bad experience in a dental chair. It stars Corbin Bernsen as a high-strung dentist who has a full-blown murderous meltdown when the pressures of his daily life become too great.
You can't see that? The stain? How could you let him send it back looking like that? I can't wear that.
I'm sorry, I must have missed it.
Now I have to wear this!
Well, what's wrong with it?
My diamond cufflinks. When I wear white shirts, I wear my diamond cufflinks, but I can't wear my diamond cufflinks because they're still at the jeweler's having the stones reset, unless, of course, you pick them up for me.
I didn't have a chance. I've been working on a fundraiser all week long.
Things are going to hell around here! This has got to stop, Brooke!
It's sort of like that Michael Douglas movie, Falling Down. You know, self-entitled white guy, perceives every little thing as a personal injustice until one day he finally snaps. Only this self-entitled white guy has a dental drill.
Doctor. Doctor. Doctor.
What? Corbin Bernsen is really good in this movie, and he's surrounded by a fantastic supporting cast that includes Linda Hoffman, Ken Foree, Molly Hagan, Patty Toy, Jan Hoag, Virginya Keehne, Earl Boen, Christa Sauls, and Mark Ruffalo. The concept is simple. Corbin Bernsen is an obsessive-compulsive prick with a nice house, a beautiful wife, and a successful dental practice.
Okay, now I want you to open your mouth nice and wide for Jessica.
After a particularly bad day in which he catches his wife messing around with the pool guy, the good dentist experiences a total psychotic break and spends the rest of the movie terrorizing everyone around him with the various tools of dental trade.
Doctor. What were you doing using that donut burr? You were destroying that woman's tooth.
Are you questioning me? Don't you think I know what my patient wants?
Doctor...
Don't ever do that again. I run this office.
Yes, I know.
When I tell you to do something, you do it! Now, get back in there and take care of the patient. Now!
The action is spread out over 2 days. On the first day, we watch the dentist fantasize about killing his wife's lover, pop a bunch of pills, kill his neighbor's dog, and generally try unsuccessfully to keep it together.
Maybe there shouldn't be a rest of the day. Maybe we should close up until things are under control.
Things are under control! Everything is under control! This is a business, Garon. My business. I cannot afford to have a bad day.
After he tortures and disfigures his wife by pulling out all her teeth, all bets are off. On the second day, everyone is a target. His staff, his clients, and especially the corrupt IRS agent who's blackmailing him.
Come on, Marv. Open wide.
For my money, the second day is where the movie really picks up.
The idea that every second, they're just... rotting away. Can you live with that? I don't think you can.
Meanwhile, a detective, played by Ken Foree, is hot on his heels after putting two and two together while investigating the dead dog from the first day.
To the lab, check out the neighbors. Cop stuff, huh?
The Dentist is an imperfect movie that doesn't always work, but it's also a lot of fun, with a solid cast and tons of squirm-inducing, goopy practical effects.
Kiss my wife, you filthy piece of shit!
Those effects were produced by a huge team of makeup effects artists, including Anthony C. Ferrante, who would go on to direct all four Sharknado movies. Well, four as of this taping. I'm sure a fifth film is right around the corner.
You've been smoking.
I have not.
You're lying to me. I can smell it on your breath. Now I have to brush my teeth again.
The film is helmed by Brian Yuzna, who also directed Return of the Living Dead 3, Silent Night, Deadly Night 4, Progeny, both Re-Animator sequels, portions of the horror anthology Necronomicon, and of course, Society.
Will you have to drill?
They're your teeth. You wouldn't want them to fall out, would you?
The script was written by Charles Finch, Stuart Gordon, and Dennis Paoli. Paoli and Gordon also collaborated on their best-known work, Re-Animator and From Beyond, but also The Pit and the Pendulum, Castle Freak, which we covered in Season 2, and Dagon. If you're a Stuart Gordon fan and you haven't yet seen The Dentist, you really owe it to yourself to give it a watch.
They're dropping like flies.
I also want to point out the inventive cinematography by the film's DP, Levy Isaacs. The Dentist is filled with creative and intricate camera moves and lighting setups, which isn't too surprising considering that he also DP'd a whole bunch of episodes of Tales from the Crypt.
You're a dentist, right?
Yes.
It's a little like a cop. A necessary evil.
I also love this film's sound design. Major props to everyone in the sound department, which notably includes Alan Howarth, who handled the film's special sound effects as well as the score. Horror fans need no introduction to Howarth, as his score collaborations with John Carpenter are legendary, having composed or co-composed Halloween 2 through 6, They Live, Prince of Darkness, Big Trouble in Little China, Christine, Escape from New York, etc., etc. And his sound effects or sound design credits include Gremlins, Poltergeist, the first six Star Trek movies, John Carpenter's The Thing, Twilight Zone the movie, Beetlejuice, Army of Darkness, and on and on and on. The sound work in The Dentist is awesome.
Oh, we've been having a little problem with our sludge filter lately, but I think we've got that all cleared up.
Ah! Ah!
The Dentist spawned a 1998 sequel called The Dentist 2, Brace Yourself. And many of the cast and crew returned, including director Brian Yuzna. And Brian Yuzna and Corbin Bernsen are slated to reteam in 2017 on a new horror film called The Plastic Surgeon, which Yuzna described as, quote, "It's basically just The Dentist, but with a few more bells and whistles," end quote. I can't wait.
It's horrible, isn't it? The discoloration. The periodontal deterioration. The smell.
The
we deal with this every day. And we clean it up. The filth they make. They hate us for it.
The Dentist is a flawed but fun horror movie that benefits from an above-average cast and crew and a great premise. I know everyone watching this has had at least one bad trip to the dentist, and this movie taps right into that. So if you're looking for something fun to watch this Halloween that plays really well with a group, with lots of gore, nudity, and medical-induced unpleasantries, forget Dr. Giggles. My vote goes to The Dentist. I recommend watching it with a big bowl of teeth-rotting Halloween candy. As of this taping, The Dentist is not available on Blu-ray. But there are a couple different bare-bones DVD releases for both Region 1 and Region 2. The version that I watched is the Lionsgate Trimark DVD from 2004, and you can usually pick this up for around $5 or $6 online.
Oh, a pulsating gum. A vial. An infected pulsating gum. Just ready and waiting for Lansing.
I want a second opinion.
My second opinion is extract.
Thanks for watching Pop Culture Beasts Halloween Horror Picks. I'm your host, Ryan Stockstad. Tell us about your worst trip to the dentist in the comment section down below. I know some of you have some great stories, and I want to read them. Be sure also to like us on Facebook and subscribe right here to the Pop Culture Beast YouTube channel to get new episodes every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday in October, right up through Halloween. Thanks again for watching. Watch horror movies. I'll see you next time.